Friends, welcome to the tutorial series on network analysis made simple. In this tutorial, we shall solve typical gate problems on network theorems. Hope you will enjoy this presentation. Let's go ahead. Friends, first let us solve the gate question from 2003. It says that a source of angular frequency 1 radian per second has a source impedance consisting of 1 ohm resistance in series with 1 henry inductance. We are required to identify the load when the maximum power is transferred out of the given options. So we know the maximum power transferred to the load depends upon the type of source and the source impedance. Also, it depends upon the type of load and the component of load impedance which is varying. If the source is DC, you know the source resistance is pure resistance, load resistance also is pure resistance which is varying, then the condition for maximum power transfer is RL is equal to RS. But when the source is AC, source impedance is complex, but the load is pure resistance varying, then the condition for maximum power transfer is RL is equal to modulus of ZF. Similarly, when the source is AC, source impedance is complex and the load impedance also is complex, but only resistance part of load is varying, then the maximum power is transferred when RL is equal to RS plus J XS plus XL. Similarly, the source is AC, source impedance is complex, the load impedance also is complex, but only reactance part of the load is varying, then the maximum power is transferred when XL is equal to minus XS. Similarly, when the source is AC, source impedance is complex and the load impedance also is complex and both resistance and reactance part are varying, then the condition is ZL is equal to ZS conjugate. So in our case, we see that the source is AC and the source impedance is 1 plus J1. How did you get this? You know, the given frequency is 1 radian per second. So 1 Henry is equal to omega L and that is equal to 1 ohm. And hence ZS is equal to 1 ohm resistance in series with 1 ohm inductive reactance. But in this case, the condition for maximum power transfer is ZL is equal to ZS conjugate. So we see that the ZL is to be the conjugate of ZS and ZS is equal to 1 plus J1 and then ZL should be equal to 1 minus J1. What does this 1 minus J1 means? It is 1 ohm resistance connected in series with 1 farad capacitance and hence option C is the correct option. Friends, next we shall solve the question from gate 2013. In this question, it is given that the source voltage Vs is equal to 100 angle 53.13 volts and we are required to identify Thevenin's equivalent voltage out of the given options. So to find the Thevenin's equivalent voltage, you know that first the load branch should be open. So you see that the load branch is open. So because the load branch is open, there are going to be certain changes that are taking place in the circuit, and identifying those changes is an important skill that you should acquire. So you see that once the load branch is open, the current I2 becomes zero because this circuit is open. And because I2 is equal to zero, you see that there is current controlled voltage source of J40 into I2, which also will be equal to 0 because I2 is equal to 0 and hence it is short circuited. You also see that I2 is equal to 0, so that the current in these two elements of J6 ohm and 5 ohm is 0, and voltage across those two elements is 0, and hence we can treat them as short circuit. So now you see that the Thevenin's voltage is equivalent to 10 times VL1. What is VL1? VL1 is the voltage across the inductance, and VL1 is equal to I1 into J4. So I1 is equal to Vs divided by 3 plus J4, and hence VL1 is equal to Vs divided by 3 plus J4 into J4, and by solving we get VL1 is equal to 80 angle 90 volts. Now we can find VThevenin. So VThevenin is equal to 10 into 80 angle 90, which will give us 800 angle 90 volts, and hence option C is the correct answer. Very, very simple, isn't it? Friends, next we shall solve the question from GATE 2005. In this question, it is given that for the circuit shown in figure, we are required to identify the Thevenin's voltage and Thevenin's equivalent resistance at the terminals A and B out of the given options. So, observe the network. You find that it is a two junction node network, and VThevenin is the voltage between A and B, and also it is the node voltage as shown in figure. Now, by writing the nodal equation for the node VThevenin, we get minus 1 plus VThevenin by 5 plus VThevenin minus 10 divided by 5 is equal to 0. By solving this simple equation, we get VThevenin is equal to 7.5 volts. Now, to find RThevenin, we have to force both independent sources to 0. So, the current source is forced to 0 by opening it, and the voltage source is forced to 0 by short circuiting it. Now, you find that this current controlled current source of 0.5 I1 is open, and hence it has no effect at all on the circuit operations. So, you also have to observe that these two 5 ohms are connected in parallel, and their equivalent is 2.5, hence RThevenin is equal to 2.5 ohm. So, VThevenin is equal to 7.5 and RThevenin is equal to 2.5, hence option B is the correct answer. Very simple, isn't it? Friends, next we shall solve the question from GATE 2007. It is given that for the circuit shown in figure, we are required to find the Thevenin's voltage and the Thevenin's resistance looking into the XY terminals. And of course, options are given and we have to choose the correct option. So if you observe the given network, you see that it is a two junction node network. So let us use the node voltage method and assume one junction node voltage as VTH. And you observe that this junction node voltage VTH also is the Thevenin's voltage across the terminals X and Y. So by writing the nodal equation for the node VTH, we get VTH minus 2I divided by 1 plus VTH by 1 minus 2 plus VTH by 2 is equal to 0. But I is equal to VTH by 1, and that is equal to VTH. So by substituting this value of I in the equation 1 obtained and solving the simple equation, we get VTH is equal to 4 volts. Now, to find the Thevenin's resistance, because the network contains the dependent voltage source of 2I volts, let us use the test voltage method to find the Thevenin's resistance. Before that, Let us force this independent current source of 2 amperes to 0 by opening it. And let us introduce a test voltage source of 50 volts across the terminals X and Y. Now, you see that this 50 volts will appear across the junction node voltage VT H instead. So let the junction node voltage be VT as shown in figure. Let IT be the current delivered by the test voltage source, and if we find the ratio of VT by IT, we get the Thevenin's resistance. So by writing the nodal equation for node VT, we get VT minus 2I divided by 1 plus VT by 1 plus VT by 2 minus IT is equal to 0. Note that. But I is equal to VT divided by 1, and that is equal to VT. So by substituting the value of I is equal to VT in the equation obtained, we get VT minus 2VT divided by 1 plus VT by 1 plus VT by 2 is equal to IT. By solving this simple equation, we get the ratio of VT by IT is equal to R Thevenin is equal to 2 ohm, and hence option D is the correct answer. Friends, next we shall solve the question from GATE 2008. It states that the Thevenin's equivalent impedance between the nodes P and Q is to be calculated, and of course options are given and we have to choose the correct option. Now, because we are required to find only Thevenin's equivalent impedance, we can as well force these independent sources to zero. So this 10 volt source is forced to zero by short circuiting it, and this 1 ampere current source is forced to zero by open circuiting it. And we also have to transfer this 1 Henry and 1 Farad into S domain. So you know Laplace transform of 1 Henry is equal to S, and Laplace transform of 1 Farad is equal to 1 upon S. Now the inductance S and the resistance 1 ohm are in series, and this can be expressed as S plus 1. Similarly, the capacitance 1 upon S and 1 ohm are in series, and it can be expressed as 1 upon S plus 1. You now see that these two series combination is in parallel with each other. Therefore, S plus 1 is parallel with 1 upon S plus 1. So actually we have already got the Thevenin's impedance. Hence Thevenin's impedance is equal to S plus 1 into 1 upon S plus 1 divided by S plus 1 plus 1 upon S plus 1. And by solving, we get S plus 1 upon S plus 2 divided by S plus 1 upon S plus 2, because both the denominator and the numerator are same, Z Thevenin is equal to 1, and hence option A is the correct answer. Very simple, isn't it? Friends, let us now solve one interesting problem from GATE 2012. In this question, it is given that the impedance looking into the nodes 1 and 2 is to be calculated, and the options are given, and we have to identify the correct option. So if you look into the given circuit, you may feel that, oh, this network is very, very complex. No, friends, absolutely the network is not complex. You can transform it into a very easy network, provided you know how to read the connectivity of the network and transform the network and redraw the network, keeping the connectivity same. So Observe that this 99 IB current source is connected between the junction nodes 1 and 2. So, let us first connect that. So, this junction 99 IB is connected between the junction, nodes 1 and 2. And what you have to observe here is, in the given circuit, the current enters node 1. So, here also you have to see that the current enters node 1. That is fine. Later, this 100 ohm is connected between 1 and 2. So, here also in the modified circuit, it is connected between 1 and 2. Fine. This also is okay. Now, this 1K and 9K are connected in series and their equivalent is 10K. And this combination of 1K and 9K is connected between the nodes 1 and 2. So, here also 10K is connected between the nodes 1 and 2. And also you observe that IB is entering node 1. So, here also in the modified circuit, IB is entering the node 1. Now, we are required to find the impedance looking into the nodes 1 and 2. And also the network contains the dependent source. Therefore, let us use the test source method and introduce a test voltage source of VT between the nodes 1 and 2. Now you see that this VT appears across this point and let this be the node voltage VT. And let IT be the current delivered by the source voltage VT. And if we find the ratio of VT divided by IT, it is the impedance looking into the nodes 1 and 2. So, let's write the nodal equation for the node VT. We get minus IB minus 99 IB plus VT by 100 minus IT is equal to 0. By just simplifying this equation, we get minus 100 IB plus VT by 100 is equal to IT. Let it be equation 1. Now, we know IB is equal to minus VT by 10K. Note that. And by substituting this value of IB in equation 1 and solving, we get VT by 100 plus VT by 100 is equal to IT. And by solving this simple equation, we get the ratio of VT by IT, which is the impedance looking into the nodes 1 and 2, is equal to 50 ohm, and hence option A is the correct answer. Very interesting and simple, isn't it? Friends, in this tutorial, we have solved some typical gate problems on network theorems. I'm sure you have enjoyed the presentation. Friends, I am open to the suggestions to improve the content and the presentation. So, feel free to comment either through the network or through my email ID. Thank you for watching.